Eurovision fam, it's Alesia Michelle. It's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time for me to react to all 41 songs in the 2019 Eurovision Song Contest, all going down in Tel Aviv, Israel. I'm going. Are you? I am super excited for Eurovision this year, and this truly is the moment I've really been waiting for. Let's get into this reaction. Play. Hey. Hey, what, Eurovision 2019, I got a new video, Alesia Michelle, I'm ready to go. Eurovision fam, are you ready for the show? So as you know, today I'm going to be reacting to all the songs, the 41 songs in the 2019 Eurovision Song Contest. I'm so excited. Play. Okay. Ooh, Albania. You know, I do feel like Albania is a little bit underrated this year, and I think this is a stronger song than they had last year. There's something, I mean, this to me is like really like my ethnic jam this year, and every time it comes on, I listen to it all the way through. Oh, so good. Ooh, Armenia. Armenia is coming strong this year. They're coming with power. Serbuk is an amazing vocalist. I'm very curious to see how this performs this year because, in a weird way, I don't know if this is like a safe bet to qualify. I don't know why I feel that way, but but it is good and it's definitely in my grand final, so. Oh. This song. Y'all are gonna start. Okay, y'all gotta stop hating on Australia and start getting into the song. Because whether you like it or not, I think there is a level of just respecting what this entry is doing. Because it is pop, her vocal is sick, and it's staged. It's gonna be staged. Okay, so we have Austria. Austria, I'm very surprised by this entry. I love the vocal. I love the styling. They're definitely going to be able to recreate this music video like on the stage in Israel. So I'm excited to see that. But I will say, I wish there was a little bit more lyrical depth to the song. When I found out what it was about, I was a little like, okay. Shut up about it. Shut up about it. Hey. Azerbaijan is coming strong this year. This is definitely an upgrade from what they were giving us last year. I definitely think this is going to be in the final. I don't see how this doesn't get to the final. I mean, the staging would have to be really bad. And they know how to stage. This is an interesting choice from Belarus. Very current, very poppy. You know, I could see like a little Zara Larsson, you know, moment happening. And this is cute. I actually don't hate this, but like it's probably not gonna be the final though, you know? It's not. Ooh, Eurovision fam, I'm gonna need y'all to wake up and stop underrating Belgium. True. I came to fight over you. Yeah, come through Belgium. Come through for the redemption. Cause I see this qualifying, hello. Ooh. I'm not gonna lie. I don't know how this song grew on me. I really don't know, but I think it's because of Braco and the vocal. I mean the vocal. Yeah. This song, it grew on me. I don't know how it happened. Hey, come through. Come on. I know you miss the taste. Come through. This is just cute. I mean, this is the thing. I don't know if Cyprus is our winner this year. I don't know. I mean, the staging is going to be top notch. The song is good. The production is good. The styling, I know, is going to be fire. But will it win? I don't know. Of a friend. She's never home because she plays in a band. Here's the thing. There is no other song like this year. And I truly think that this should be in the final. It might be tough, it might be cutting it close, but I think that this should be in the final. Like, there's no song like this year. It's the only one. Oh, and then we have Denmark. You know, I just think with this song, it's such a light song. It's so kind of cute. But the staging doesn't feel cute. And I think they should embrace the song a little bit more, like with the black and white, you know, and then kind of the dark staging. I think if we had some purples, some pinks, it could help. And we'll be safe and sound. There are a lot of people hating on this song. I am not one of them. I really like this song. And when it all comes down, we just need this song to be sung very well because the staging is done and the songwriting is top notch. And there's a lot of people hating on Finland. I do think Finland is in trouble when it comes to qualifying. It's in my final, I think. I like it. I do. I really like it. And I just think what we need to do with the staging is really polish it and give us some rich camera angles. Quand je rêve, je suis en roi. Okay. France, I've told y'all my opinions on France. I need more vocal. I like this song, though. That's a crazy thing. I really like the song. I just need more vocal. I need more vocal in the song. Ocean, you trying to be in the video? Please don't. I'm gonna say something nice about this song. I like him. He is selling the mess out of this song on a teeny tiny stage with some like rando pyro. And I think that there's something about that, I mean, he's selling the song. He is selling it. This song, I feel like I gotta wait till I get to Tel Aviv. Cause this note, sister, that note alone for me is like top notch. Like that note, that harmony note gets me every single time. The rest of it, I'm not really into. Ooh, Greece coming for redemption. But all they need to do is make sure this staging is tight. If this staging is tight, I mean, it's so good. It's so good. It's so good. Who you waiting for? You know, I'm gonna say this. This might be an unpopular opinion. I am concerned for Hungary this year. But I like it. But I'm concerned, like, is it enough to, like, make it in the final? Na 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 na. Ooh. Yeah. I really, really like this, but I'm nervous for it. Ooh, my friend Sean said this about Triana Park, but I'm gonna say it about Iceland. This is like my experimental drug phase song. Hey, I'm into it. I listened to this all the way through now. All the way through. This is gonna be a moment on the stage. It should be in the final. You know, I like this song. I'm not a fan of this visual, you know, to sell the song. So I'm very, like, I have no clue what Ireland is going to do on stage. But I'll tell you right now, if you just have her standing there behind a microphone singing the song, it's not going to be enough. So Israel's song this year, to me, sounds like it should be in a musical. It sounds like it should be in a musical. Check out my blog on ESC Extra, because I wrote a whole musical that I feel like this song should be in. I basically created a whole musical for the song. Hey. Eurovision fam, have y'all forgotten about Italy? I hope you haven't. I haven't forgotten about Italy. This is a potential winner for us, and we need to start acting like it, okay? Because this is fire, and I would love to go to Italy. Are you love? It's so weird because I actually really prefer the live version of this. I like the way her vocal comes through on the live version. In the studio version, the song kind of sounds monotonous, and we need more dynamism from it. Come on, run wild, run with the lions. Y'all gotta stop talking about jury juice. Y'all gonna stop talking bad about my boyfriend, okay? I'll never walk away, na-na. Hey, Malta. Malta coming through. Come a chameleon. Hey, this is my shit. This is good. Malta, stage it right. Stage it right. Moldova is giving us, you know, Celine Dion 1996 tease. Heavy. What's in my cup? I have some local Maryland rum and Coca-Cola. It's delicious. This song, at least they're giving us vocal. Ooh, it's my most improved award. Your heart calling into my heart. Okay, come on. Yeah. Montenegro, you know, they really turned it around. They did what they could, and they turned this track around, and it's a cute little S Club 7, you know, 98 vibe. You know, Tamara's about to get on that stage and sing for us, and I have to say, I'm concerned that this probably won't end up in the final, but it's a great song. I did say it was like a little literal for me, but it's a great song. Nine. And classic Eurovision, Norway giving us what Eurovision is. Hey. Hey. Oro, ero, Eli. I cannot wait to meet them because I'm going to be getting a full yoking lesson. And I'm excited about that. If you saw my reaction to Poland, I like this. Some of y'all don't like it. I feel like I get it. I feel like it's very girl pop, funk, rock, angsty, icona pop moment. Ooh. I'm still in love. Hey, Portugal. Just making me happy. Just making me happy. Ooh, yeah. This song I still listen. I listen to every day, more than once. It's so good. It's so good. It's so good. Every day. So Romania, I think they're back in the final this year. They're back in the final this year. This video is super extra though too, and makes me feel like, okay, you know, the staging is about to be like super extra because this video is extra. Sergey coming back for redemption. Yeah, I'm curious to see how this all comes together. I'm serious. I'm curious to see how voters at home receive this. Because, you know, I mean, it is what it is. Sergey is singing, but is this the best song? Hey, say na na na. Look. I don't know if San Marino is in my final. I don't know if it's in my final. I don't know if I could put it there. But this is good. Like, this could have been a hot ass mess. And it's not. Like, this is good. And then Serbia coming with the classics. The thing about this song is, to me, this is very Eurovision. It's a great vocal. We've got great styling. She looks great. Like, I am confident that this song will be performed well. But this year, I think it's a little tough. I don't know. Ooh. This song is a mood. It's a vibe. I hope people appreciate it. I think I would feel some type of way if this didn't end up in the final. Hey. Come through, Spain. Hey. Lavender ya cayó. Spain, be proud. I'm proud for you because this is like one of the best entries you have given me. This is better than Say Yay. This is better than, the one that I really like. Yeah, yeah. Better, yeah. And then we have Sweden. I'm not surprised that they chose this clip of the song, you know, when the background singers are out there. I'm not surprised because that's the clip that I would have chosen. You know, Sweden's doing what they do, giving us quality, you know. Yeah, I wish I had a little bit more from that vocal, though. Yeah, because it's a little bit like boy bandy does pop, that like does gospel. Hey, hey, come through Switzerland. Woo, hey, what? It's the Fuego of this year. Not saying that it's a copy of Fuego, but saying that it is the moment that we need and could potentially come second place at Eurovision because it's so much fun. Hey, Dirty Dancing. Oh, y'all already know. Loving you is a losing game. Oh, come through. Oh my God. Netherlands. So good. So good. So good. But Netherlands has been giving us quality. They've been giving us quality. So, you know, I think it's about due time we reward them. And y'all gonna stop talking about the UK. It's bigger than us. Cause Michael Rice might be one of the best male vocalists we have this year. He's got a rawness about him. He's got the range. He is going for it. Look at him hitting these notes. He is going for it. Oh my God. Yes, Boo Boo sing. Sing, Boo, sing. Oh, it's bigger. Yeah, come through with the runs. Woo! Well, that was my reaction to all 41 songs for Eurovision 2019. What do you think? Talk to me in the comments below. Do you agree with my comments? Talk to me in the comments below. Do you disagree with me? That's okay too. Talk to me in the comments below. This is a conversation and you know it. I am so excited for Eurovision 2019. Don't forget to like and to subscribe because I got more content coming for ya. Bye.